Welcome to another video. We're going over Finisher Retro by one of my favorite plugin companies, UJAM. What I like about UJAM is everything's easy, just takes a couple of buttons and you get something that sounds good. Traditionally, they make virtual instruments, but recently they've been creeping into this mixing area with their Finisher series of plugins. And I'll have to admit, it took me a while before I was on board with these, but with this plugin is going to give people a lot of that polished finish mixing sound without having to do a lot of the work here. This is retro. It says it's vibey and vintage and cool. And you know you're getting old when 90s is vintage. So we got 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s. What's great about these is you're basically controlling, I believe it's 20 effects modules with just a couple of knobs and buttons. So it's very simplified. You tweak one. If it sounds better, you keep it. If it doesn't, you change it and you try again. You can just go through these really quick. And right now it's on sale. It's very affordable at this point. And if for some reason you missed the sale, think about getting the Finisher bundle as well, because you get all of the Finisher plugins, which I'm not going to go into detail here, but they operate on a similar basis. But honestly, retro seems to be the most complete to me. The effects chains are designed with a purpose in mind instead of like just random things thrown together. Let's dive into Studio One here. Okay, so we're in Studio One, and I made this track very quickly using Orb Producer. If you haven't seen the Orb Producer tutorial, there should be a link somewhere. So I've done some just very basic mixing, just adjusted levels on the virtual instruments that I'm using. And for a couple of these, I've used Shaperbox and Kilohertz Bit Crush. There's also a built-in Bit Crusher in Studio One, which works fine. I just grabbed that one for no particular reason. So this melody at the beginning sounds like this. And then after Finisher Retro. Now it's not a super amazing difference, but it definitely puts some dirt on it. Makes it sound like something that was recorded in the 70s from a string machine, which is like a mellotron. Now, of course, there's tons of these effects. So those are all in the decade of the 70s, and then you have the 80s. And you can adjust the amount overall. And as you move this knob, it changes the degree to which everything is affected. And then there are a few parameters for each module. So, very simple to use. I could see where that could come in handy. This is the original sound. This is with the effect. So you can see how quickly you can get a sort of finished sound. Okay, so we'll just go back to the 70s and string machine, which is what I had it on. And let me just readjust that a little bit. I think I had it about here. And I made it a little darker. And you can actually make it an older machine, get a little bit of dropouts. And I really like the way that sounds. So then this sound, this flute sound is very clean. If I turn on the retro, we've got a bit crusher and delay type of effect going on. Fills up the spectrum, sounds bigger, and sounds somehow cleaner, even though I know it's making it more dirty. So I've just used a couple of these effects on a couple of tracks to polish them. And as an experiment, I put a Finisher Retro on the entire drum track. So this is all of the drums to one bus, and we'll just listen to it with it on. This is the transistor colors. This is Transformer Overkill. You can adjust. Obviously overkill. With drums, you're gonna be limited a little bit as to how many of these you could actually use. That's pretty cool though. I don't think I would use it on drums, but there are a few that you could. I kinda like this thing. Just turn down the color. Adjust the overload, how much it smears. So cool. could do this as like a parallel effect if you wanted to. Obviously, that's a little dirty, but you get the point. And it's super easy to go through all of these effects so fast. So these effects chains take a lot of time to make. And you could argue that you could do all of the effects yourself inside of the DAW. And you could manually add more compression and then more delay and then more reverb and morph between the two. But this plugin does it so simplistically that you get to access complicated effects chains in a very quick, easy manner. And what's really cool is you could also automate any of these things. So you could automate all of these knobs. So you're even getting an even more complicated effects assignment to your tracks. And so this is really adding that sort of pro level mixing, paying attention to things that mixers do, that if you're an artist and you're trying to make stuff fast, get songs done, if you will, this thing is, I really believe this plugin and plugins like this are going to speed that up for people. If you want to get Finisher Retro, just click the link in the description. And on that note, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up. And if you want to get songs done faster, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Make sure you hit the bell. And sometimes I have bonuses in the descriptions of my videos, so check down there, see if I've got it up there yet. And until next time, keep making music. Be sure to watch another video and also get songs done.